Bobby, I'm going to perform our presentation. Do you like to pay our high respect to my director of Institute of 25? We would like to pay our high respect to three committees who are judgment, commendation, and building score. We would like to pay our high respect to Mr. Sun Samara, who is our supervisor for number one. Hello, all the audience who are present here, and especially to a group number who are going to perform today. Good afternoon and congratulations. Today, it is a beautiful day for us to perform our presentation. However, before we are going to start, we would like to introduce ourselves first.
My name is Vinara, I'm responsible for introduction.
My name is Kim, I respond lesson plan.
My name is Kanon, and I respond for the classroom measurement.
My name is Tanisan, and I respond for teaching methodology.
And the last, my name is Tetralang, I'm respond about conclusion. So, the first part is welcome to Mr. Darab to respond about introduction. Please.
As like you know already, in year 4 semester 1 and 2, we have been learned five subjects. Teaching methodology is the way that conduct or method for teacher to where people have before they go into teaching in the real class. We learn how to where prepare and lesson plan, strategy and method to be a good teacher in the real class, and strategy to take grammar to the student in the good way. Foundation of education, the fundamental and the studying of education apply in education in the organization or the company. And we learn the form of education, such as informal education, non-formal education, and formal education. And we learn based on 21st century learning, as like inquiry based learning and project based learning as well. Research methodology is the way that we analyze or create the new world of innovation. And we learn a lot of from this subject, as like we learn how to summarize, how to paraphrase or make a citation in the practical folder. And one more thing, especially we learn how to conduct, or we will know the mindset or what the philosophical or physical of the student and all the practicum journey as well. And translation and interpreting, we have two main point definition. Translation is the way we make equivalent from source language to type and language. And we have been learned the process of translation and the kind of translation, as like human translation and machine translation. Interpreting is the way we interpret immediately between a soft language to another language. And we also learn as like a translation as well, the process of interpreting and the kind of interpreting. Apply linguistics, we learn how to apply the language or we solve the problem of language in the real life and in education as well. And we learn a lot of from the subject. We learn how to solve the problem between another language to other language. For some objective of our practicum, to put the journey in the real practice, make the trainee acquire or get a lot of experience from our practicum before we are going to be a teacher and make the trainee have confidence and expertise. Okay, that's it for my point, and let's go to our group member, Ms. Sok Kim Mai, who are respond lesson plan.
Mr.
Dara,
for your nicely presentation. Now, let's move to part two. It's the lesson plan. What is the lesson plan? The lesson plan is the guide of the lesson to running in the class to go smoothly and correctly. Lesson plan has two tabs. They are PPP, presentation, practice, production, or PPR, presentation, practice, lesson. And other one is POS or PRR, POS, presentation, review, skill, or PRR, presentation, review, lesson. The arm of the PPP or PR is to introduce the new language. We can use it in the grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. For the objectives of the PPP or PPR, at the end of the lesson, the student can get know about grammar and get correctly and effectively. And for the PPP or PPR, it has 5 steps. They are lesson opener, warm up, presentation, practice, and lesson closer. For the POR or POS, for the arm, it is to practice the new language. We can use it in new four. We can use in four micro skills such as reading, speaking, listening, and reading. For the objectives of the POR or POS, to make the student become to use reading grammar to get smoothly and fluency. For the lesson plan, we have 3 processing. They are before, during, and after. For the lesson plan, it is the action that we do for go to the class. Set up, we need to know about the lesson that what the lesson that we do. So we need to select the type of lesson plan to relate our lesson. And for the during of the class, we will use our lesson plan that we set before to run our class. However, we have the lesson plan, but sometimes we still meet the problem, such as the student still misunderstand the question of the student is difficult. So we need to be flexible to solve this problem. For the after lesson plan, we need to evaluate student how much our student understand, how much the student can use our lesson to apply their daily. And for the challenge that we face to do lesson plan, it has 2: failure to achieve the objectives, and the second is well prepared. So for the solution to do fail achievement to at this. We need to explain our student to get clearly, slowly, and review them and give the assistant to them to do it. And for the well prepare, we need to look or check our lesson plan and give it to our supervisor to verify it. And thank you. And for this point, please come back to my member, Mr. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Kimai. We see the challenges or the problem in the classroom management. We do the solution like be flexible of the class like of time management. Like when students come to do exercise or something, we can give them the answer sheet and they can learn it at home or can ask for the letter. And the last is getting ready. It means that teacher should prepare thing ready like document or answer sheet or material, some material that relate to the teaching lesson. So after we face the problem and we find the solution, we can find the mistake that we made and we turn it into the experience and correct it. Like I mentioned it already, that teachers should be prepared, well prepared for the teaching material. And for the some point that not important, teacher can be flexible on it. Okay, so it's all about my point. Now let's move to Mr. Isar to respond for the next.
And it's now it's my point to present about my part, which is talking about teaching methodology. So I want to give you about short detail about teaching methodology. Teaching methodology is a technique or a strategy that teacher use in their lesson to make their lesson more effectively to the student. And in teaching methodology, there are two parts of it. Two kinds of it. Sorry. The first kind is teacher-centered approach. Teacher-centered approach means the teacher is more active than the student. And the second kind is student-centered approach. Student-centered approach, which means the student is more active than the teacher. It means they do more tasks than the teacher. And now let's move to my point. About my point today, I'm going to share you about my experience that I have during my teaching practice. The first is before my teaching practice. Before my teaching practice, the first that I do is choosing the right method. In my case, I was teaching about reading. So, which means I choosing student-centered approach, because student-centered approach basically support the four macro skills such as reading, writing, listening, and speaking, reading, writing, and listening. The second is I have to prepare the activity for the student, such as the individual activity or the group activity. And let's move to the during my teaching practice. When I start my lesson, I pick out the student to read the text, since my lesson was about reading. And the rest of the class was reading along them quietly. And after the reading, I separate them into two groups. The first group was answering the question in the first part of the text, the article, and the second group was answering the question about the second part of the article. And after they answering the question already, I let them share their answer to the whole class. And now I go to the about the after my teaching practice. After my teaching practice, I able to use the method more effectively. Because after I had practice, after I had teaching practice, I realized myself and also some comment from the supervisor. I know my good point and point that I need to improve. And now let's go to the challenges that I had or difficulty that I had. The first is I'm focused on too much about the textbook. It means that when the student was reading, I was reading alongside them. And I didn't notice some students that were talking to each other or they didn't pay attention to the class. So that is my first difficulty. And the second one is I don't give a clear instruction to the student. For example, there are two parts of the article and there was two groups. And I didn't tell which group until which part of the article. So in during the answering the question, they confused and they told me what should they do during that because I don't give them the clear instruction. So and now is the solution. The first solution is the monitor and pay attention to the student. Even though I use student center approach, which means the student is more active than the teacher did. And that doesn't mean that the teacher sits still and do nothing. But in fact, the teacher should monitor, walk around the class, and checking them if they need help. And the second point is to explain them step by step and give example if possible. And reason for that is I need to explain one group by at a time. For example, in group A you should answer the question in part A of the article, and group B you should answering the question in part B of the article. And overall, I think I did a great job because at the end of the class, the student did answering my question very well. And that's all of my part. And finally, let's go to Ms. Tsai Lai to explain her part.
For your free presentation. So everyone, so now let's go to the last part of our teaching break time is about conclusion. So to sum up of our teaching break time, there are four important parts. The first is about introduction. An introduction that have five subjects in new course semester 1 and 2. They are Appalling Mistake, Teaching Methodology, Appalling Research Methodology, Interpretation and Interpreting, and Foundation of Education. And yes, in each subject, I play important role for each student, not only me, but the whole. And those subjects can apply for a teacher that when they finish a bachelor degree of English. And that for subject, we found that it helped us in teaching very kind. So such as teaching methodology, classroom management, and also applying this thing. Those part of subjects can help us, like when we come to the real class, if we mention about the teaching methodology, so what technique or measure that the teacher applies to teach the student, and what the classroom, how classroom management, so how the teacher use the classroom management effectively to apply to the real class. And about the applying this thing, it also includes in our teaching curriculum, because even though we are a teacher, we also face some problem. So after we finish that, we know how to show a problem. We know how flexible teacher is. And the second point is talk about lesson plan. Like as one of my members mentioned, lesson plan is the guide or map that helps the teacher to apply his or her lesson into the class. And the most important parts of the lesson have two kinds, PPP, or POL, presentation practice production, or presentation practice lesson. And it's M and it's to introduce a new language. So it's gonna focus, the lesson is about grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. And about the objective of this type of lesson, at the end of the lesson, the student will be able to use the new language correctly and effectively. And in teaching grammar, the teacher can apply two approaches. The first is about deductive. So deductive means that the teacher pick the student from general to specific, or it means that from example to form. For example, if today the lesson of the teacher is about passing poll, so he or she gonna write the example on the board, and then he or she gonna ask the student, "Hey student, can you write the form of this sentence?" It's something like that. And the last is about deductive. Deductive is the teacher use this approach of teaching grammar. He or she gonna give the form. No, sorry. Give the form, and then let the student find out example. It means that from specific to general. And number three is about classroom management. So in classroom management, it's very important for a new teacher. Why am I saying that? Because in classroom management, the new teacher has not enough experience to apply. Whether they check that classroom environment is safe for the student, have enough material, can control the student well, whether that class is mid level or the same level. And the last is about teaching methodology. And teaching methodology here is also difficult for a new teacher, because if the teacher, like if he or she is the first time of teaching, he or she has enough experience to apply those measures or techniques to reach the class smoothly and fluently. And after our teaching program, we found the challenges. The first is about lack of time management. So this is occur in every teacher that applies, and also when they come to teach. For example, when I teach in my class at the time, you know what? The electricity went off. So what's going on? It's dark, right? Cannot continue the lesson. So what I'm gonna do? I take my phone to light it, and everyone also has a phone, so that's why. plan was late because of the time. Even though that form is can have a life, but it's quite difficult for them. So my time that I have set, it might be over. So that's why I will be occur and have time and can be late to my other next class to continue this point. So yeah. And lack of awareness, even though I used to teach a kid, but you know, at that time, I'm not keep that kid as like I. It's my about my experience. It's about the high level then. So how is my what I want to talk about is like I'm gonna forget and what I plan is out of my. Like it means that what I have said is not the same to what I'm gonna keep. It's like that. And yes, after that we found that solution, or we faced the challenge or difficulty in our teaching program at those times. We also found the solution. The first is time arrangement and student flexibility. So even though at that time we still over and over our time management, but we also said that even though that time is over for each member, but we still continue and reach our teaching pretty. And the student need and adaptable. Yeah. Even though we have a lesson plan, but it doesn't mean that in the class is not moving through your lesson plan. So you have to see that what is the student need, and the teacher gonna follow the student need, also adaptable and make it easy and short but clear. And the last is build confidence. So even though I feel nervous to see my student is a high level, but what I have to do is build up my confidence. I also finally finish my lesson smoothly. So yeah, after we finish our teaching program, we have the achievement in our process. Like we gonna turn the mistake we can make that mistake into experience. Yeah, sure. Even though that time we also have good product and form to be improved. So we're gonna collect those things to be exposed that. Even though not mean that you are picked only one time, but you're gonna have another time or you apply to a teacher. So you gonna take note that those mistake had happened already. So will you take the mistake to apply it again? It might be not, right? It gonna like we remember that those technique, those mistake is not freak, it's not success for us. So take it out, leave it out, right? So be a real teacher. In being a teacher, he not mean that you are come to take only one time, but when you come to take. You are teacher for them and they are a student. So don't think that, I just come today, so please don't think that I am not your teacher. Don't think like that, because when you come to teach, you also be a teacher already. So they are a student. And the last is build up confidence. As like I mentioned, even though my experience is used to teach only kids, but and after that, about my other time, I was very stuck, and I don't know what I'm gonna do with them. I'm so nervous. I'm afraid of you. Like you are looking at me. So I'm gonna continue my teaching. Yes, so I'm gonna continue it. So this is my confidence. And the last one is about collaboration and the apprenticeship. Yeah, sure. In that teaching curriculum, even though each of us without like work communication, work in group, not time, like in order to process this slide or this like new result get from today, because of us get involved together and help each other. So the last, I would like to, in the point of suggestion and recommendation, I have three. The first is about student, Dongsa. So right now, our generation is finished. So the next generation, what are gonna do for the term? When they take this bachelor, so the student have to master in its five parts. So what are the five parts in teaching curriculum? The one is introduction, lesson plan, classroom management, teaching methodology, and conclusion. So they have to be master of five parts, not only one. Okay, I'm gonna respond to this point, and I focus only this, but not me like that. We're gonna master all the parts. And active with group member and supervisor. Yeah, sure. The result comes from today because of us get involved and with the chief, with the supervisor. Without them, or without he, my our supervisor, we cannot stand here and see all you guys. And attend in orientation class. Yeah, be sure. In the, before we start this process, the school also provide the orientation class for the like for us, you for semester two, they nearly finished, or we are nearly finished our bachelor we're gonna do it. So they have the orientation for them to get the experience what are the points that we're gonna do and what are the steps or process. And we're prepared before different day. Yeah, sure. Five of us can stand here and talk and share to you. Not only mean that we never discuss or we never have something the result come from today, because we have done it day by day and every single day that we gonna collect from each of us to combine in one slide. And dean and lecturer, so we really thank you for all you guys, for your hard working and sharing your experience, and also to have us to be stand here. However, we still need your help more than this, and also your time. And the last is about school. Please keep in this process for the next generation. It's not mean that our generation is gonna die, but not mean that the next generation cannot continue this state, but please continue for them. And the last is, it's 10 more time for teaching curriculum. Yeah, sure. Even though that we are finished this stuff, we still need more time to do more research and get more knowledge and skill for this part, this process also. So our presentation is finished. So thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For all of you. How do you feel today?
I feel cool and so sleepy when I drink water.
Yes, why not?
Okay, thank you.
I showed the sign that you should bring the water for her. Because she talked, I thought she might be tough off and speaking.
When I look at five of you, and some of you just feel a little bit nervous.
Even me!
Some of you feel simple. All right, anyway, thank you so much for your presentation today. And I am happy to be here with you guys, but after happy, something will happen to you is the questions. All right. Are you ready for my question?
Ready.
Yes.
All right. And let's say same again for all five that begin the presentation. And I am really appreciate thing to you guys. But the question is related to I mean perhaps it is all of you, right? All of you. And I would like you to make a little bit detail related to what you have learned in year 4, right? What you have learned in year 4 and how it supports your teaching process. Start from, sir. I need only tools of you, right? Right, two of you just respond for my question.
Okay, thank you. For me, regarding who that quite subject we, since we learn since semester 1 year 4, we can make it support us for our different and our practical program. Because we need to write it down and make it in our slide different, two different in here right now. That's it for my answer.
So another one, please.
So thank you for your question. So in year 4 semester 1 and 2, those 5 subjects are play important role in order to make this teaching process, to make the teaching curriculum successfully. So as like a mentioned, just finished my presentation, like classroom management, teaching methodology, applying linguistic, translation and interpreting, and foundation of education. The last is research methodology. Like we stand here and we can see the result here because we take one of the subject is about translation and interpreting. So this is the process of communication. How well we use it, how well we take from the subject to apply in our process. And about in classroom management, in teaching methodology, we take those skills that we have learned from the lecturer to apply in our project. And the last is about applied linguistics. So as we know that applied linguistics is the big, is the complete subject that we have studied both semester. So after we got the problem, we try to find it step by step. So we're gonna see that where the problem come from and how to end and how to complete or to find that problem together. Thank you, teacher.
Thank you so much. And I am still interested in a similar question as you mentioned in details. So among all the subjects in the year 4 that you have been taught and learned, so what subject is the most important to support your teaching practice and the reason why?
Okay.
I need another one.
I think that for the all subjects that I have studied in the year 4, I see that teaching methodology is important for our process of our teaching curriculum. Because in the teaching methodology, taught us to guide us to how to write the lesson plan, how to teach the student, to control the student, and also have the methodology that can apply for the student in the classroom correctly and simply. It's all about my question, about my answer.
Another one answer.
I think it is all the subject is important because it has eight unique points in it. Because in teaching methodology, we all know about how to write lesson plan, how to control students, and in the research between if we are teaching about grammar, we have to do a research of it. And apply, we are apply the method of the teaching as well. And also translation and interpreting, and some word that we didn't know and how to translate if we don't know how to translate or that word, we still don't know what the meaning, the content of it. And
okay, thank you so much. I will move on to another questions. Actually, today is the last day for you guys finish your practicum process. So I need you talk briefly and the activities from the start until the end for today. Yes, talk briefly in the practicum process. Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. For the practice camp, firstly, the first day that we start to do our practice camp, we need to go to listen the teacher to know about what is the practice camp. What is the practice camp that how the action that how the action that we have to do it, and then we come to the class. We will to separate the group, and then we select. We need to request teacher to get the supervisor to guide us to do the practice camp, and then we need to understand the step of the practice camp. Like the content of the practice camp, what is it, and then we share, and then we go to the research, and moreover we need to discuss our supervisor what did we do for our practice camp, and then we research, then we come to meet and share our researcher, and then discuss with our supervisor, and then we combine it into the practicum folder, and then we still research and edit, and then finally we will do a book that called the practicum to build our advisor to evaluation to verify it. What is wrong, what is right, and need to approve it. And then we need to do the slide. We need our team to do the present and know about other action to well prepare before we go to the fun.
Thank you so much. And I will move on to two more questions. I would like you to specify a little bit about the activity. For example, you are teaching in the classroom, right? You face the problem, all right?
Yes.
The first one, how you solve the problem, right? And second one, what is the new point? What is the new thing that you have never met before and you find it? Do you get my question?
Yeah.
Yes. So I would like you to specify a little bit. Please.
Can you?
Can I first?
The first one, please.
Me. Okay, thank you, teacher, for your question. So, related to that problem that happened in my class is that I don't know the reason that the problem comes from, because that when I come to teach, I don't know what is my lesson gonna teach, so the student cannot understand, the student cannot involve and interact with me and with my lesson. And that new point that I found is that after I know that my big point, so what I'm gonna do is that I cannot continue my lesson. It means that that lesson you cannot continue or you cannot go on. So please don't go on. Just stop and try to find that problem happened already. So don't jump up to the next point. This is my what I have felt, what I felt and I found it. Thank you.
Thank you. And for another one.
Okay, for me, teacher. Sorry, for me, if I get that. The first thing that I question on my practical exam since December. I have only short time before I'm the last one, and I don't know how to answer the question from the student. They ask me well, because I'm not well prepared at the time, but I can make all the students and try to keep answer. And my time is short, and I is the one teach them get the clearly and be on time, although I am have only short time. That's it for my point here at the time.
And because of the time, thank you so much, and I will move this question to Mr. Han, right? To ask you to continue the right.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Philip. Actually, some of my questions that I plan to ask you, Mr. Philip, already asked you. So, the time is short, I would like to ask you just a question, and everyone you can share to answer the question, the first one or the answer the second one can. Okay. We have talked much about lesson plan, right? We have talked about the type of lesson plan, and you also talk about the importance of lesson plan. You already said that the lesson plan is important for teaching. For example, there is a teacher who has long experience in teaching, and he or she also expertise in his or her skill. Is it fine to him without preparing the lesson plan before teaching? If yes, why? If no, why not?
Can I?
Anyone?
Absolutely, I'm gonna say yes. The reason why, the reason why that I say yes, because that teacher have enough experience and long with teaching. In that point, like I mentioned, in teaching methodology, it's very difficult for a new teacher because he or she doesn't know how to apply the measure, the technique, the approach, but which one gonna apply. But to him, he's old enough and like careful in teaching. So that he gonna apply the technique like recently, like 21st century like equally but learning. He or she is gonna give a topic for the student and let them discuss whether in group, peer group or solo. So this is the reason that I say yes. Thank you.
For her, yes. And about the other, you say also yes?
In my opinion, I think it's the opposite way.
Yeah.
Because when they if they say, sorry, let's say that he mastered it. If he mastered it, it means that the book is very old. And if there was a new edition, it might be changed some content. So it to be prepared than to be wrong to the student. He need also to prepare the lesson plan also. And that's all my point.
Thank you. and one the other, you have
okay.
The same as the same line opinion or different or
more? In one class, I go with the line opinion. Although the teacher can be that he or her only done from but he or her mean try to get to look the book because we have the new edition and English have the update from day to day.
Mm-hmm.
Because some words if it come from a new one, if they don't try to read the book or just read the book before they do teaching, their capacity or ability to provide to the student must be wrong. Although in now it is a 21st century in quite advanced learning. But they need to read the book or check the book beforehand, before they come to teaching the student. Also they are old enough, but they should prepare the lesson plan and check the book first. That's it for my point, if I like that.
Yes. Yeah, I think that it's not can be teach because the lesson plan, you know, that
is it fine to him or no?
That no, I think that
not prepare the lesson plan.
No. Yeah, because the lesson plan is very important. Even though he is the teaching, he's teaching every of the high experience, but he need to prepare the lesson plan because the lesson plan can guide him to. Finish the lesson well and smoothly, even though he have the high experience already, but some subject in the book not the same. They can be changed some point. So he need to look to the book again and get a lesson plan to apply for the student. Okay, it's all about my answers.
Okay, thank you. Would like to answer?
Yes, yes. For me, I think. If the teacher must read the word, he need to know.
But first you should answer yes or no.
Yes.
Okay, please.
Yes. Because teacher need to know this book is clear or edition that he has been do lesson plan before or not.
Mm-hmm.
So if he has been to do it, right now he go to teach, it is again.
Mm-hmm.
So he have already experienced to do to teach it, so no need to do.
Mm-hmm.
But in how the new edition, so we need to teacher need to do it. So before go to class, teacher must to have the lesson plan and know about what did he teach in today.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is my opinion.
Okay, thank you. I think that's all for my question. And Mr. Philip is not here. I would like to sum up and give some advice based on to your presentation, what you have to care to defend your corner of time. Yes. I see that your group have prepared well. Yes, and you manage the time for talk and take turn from one candidate to one candidate. Yes, I appreciate it. And you talk naturally. You don't like try to remember what was written in the book?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, what you like is your comprehension. And you also have some small point to improve your English pronunciation and some sentence structure that you use, but I think it's fine if you have more time to practice. Okay. If you have more time, you can read your course book again. I already your outcome folder, sorry, that you have prepared. I have checked it. I spent around nearly more than one day because I took it last week. I checked it again and again. Yes, because. They would like to see how the quality of the practicum folder that you have prepared. I saw that almost more than around 90% acceptable, but you have some problem
that I already folded the page that let me change. As in the reflection paper, okay, I think maybe you confused. In reflection paper, I require you to write in group. Is it right?
Yes, thank you.
But you still use some pronoun with the word I. So you do not write one person for represent any. You write in the name of the group. So I would like you to change the subject pronoun or any pronouns in reflection paper. In journal it's okay because there is your personal. But for your group, I just like you to see it again. Yes, and I already fold it for you. And I hope that after this you can take it in and can do it better. I already give some feedback about what they have done well and some recommendation. Okay. Do you have any more?
No. Thank you so much. Okay. Let's move.
No.
We need a supervisor. Just give some points.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Okay. So, thank you very much for all the comment and feedback, and especially a lot of questions from Mr. Din. Okay. So, I hope that after you got this comment and feedback from all of the committee, and okay, you can go through your folder again and just re-examine and change all those parts. We can say okay, maybe a lot of things that you need to make it to be more consistency before submitting to the school. And after this, I also recorded your different a video, maybe you can see and improve it based on this one. Okay, and the other thing, and regarding to, we can say if you love to be a teacher, lesson planning still important for the teacher. Okay, more or less the teacher still need planning, we can say, but the way that that no wise teacher or experienced teacher, they do the same do the different way, we can say if the teacher should go into the classroom without a lesson plan or without planning a lesson, it will be disaster. We can say the disaster in the class in here, because you don't know, we can say like the teacher may not know what to do or what to start or what are the activities should they apply, and the class will be messy and they cannot achieve the thing there. So okay, in this part we can say the experienced teacher, they also plan, but they may use the lesson note rather than a lesson plan sometimes, you can say, right? So if you just go to the class without planning anything, it is impossible there, even though you have 10 year or even 20 year teaching experience, but it still faces the challenges there. Like somehow your answer is just also one way, we can say you may have 10 year experience, but the textbook normally update within 5 years, so you also need to prepare for those things. At least read and take note the point that you want to teach the student in here. Alright, so okay, all of those things that I hope that you share experience from the teaching practicum, from the coursework, and from today, it's just a great experience there, and then just use it to apply. Okay. And one more thing, if you want to learn more, you can become a teacher. But if you want to become a rich man, should not be a teacher. Okay, just kidding. All right. Okay, that's it. Thank you for this part, and good luck.
Thank you. That's all, but we need to have a photo taken together, right? Who is the photo?